Greetings, everyone. This is Michael, and welcome back to another movie review. Today's film, Night Watch. Shot of the back, guys. Comes in this nice little slipcase here. Same picture inside as usual. Different picture on the back. But Night Watch is a Russian film that I happened to come across while searching Amazon for movies. It was actually one of my recommended buys by Amazon. I read the synopsis and I thought it sounded interesting. Now, as I said, Night Watch is a Russian film. It's been dubbed into English. And this is, for Russia anyway, a big budgeted film. It cost around $4 million. And the film was picked up by 20th Century Fox and released under their sister company, Fox Searchlight Films, I believe. And Fox licensed the film for $4 million, and they actually made a profit of $33 million here in the U.S. when they released it. Now, the film flew over my radar. I'd never heard of it. Definitely never heard that it was actually released here in the U.S., but like I said, sounded like an interesting film, so I decided to give it a watch. And let me tell you guys, I'm going to try to go over the story, which there's so many things happening in this film, I don't want to spoil it for anybody, but in the film, at the very beginning, in medieval times, there are people known as others. Now, there are light others, and there are dark others. And, of course, the light represent the good, and the dark represents the bad. Now, these are people that are either witches, vampires, human beings with some extraordinary power, some supernatural power. And there's this big fight at the beginning, and the leaders of both the light and the dark realize that they're so evenly matched that they're just going to annihilate each other. So they make this truce where they form two groups, the Night Watch and the Day Watch. Now, the Night Watch is a representation of the good, and the Day Watch is the bad. And basically, they police each other. So this truce is carried to present day. And in the present time, when the film switches to the future, we meet our starring character named Anton. Now, Anton, at the very beginning of the film, and, you know, guys, honestly, I'm not even sure if I want to give that away, but let me think, would that spoil anything for you? Let's just say that Anton gains the ability to see the others. Now, normal people can't really see the others. But Anton discovers that he can, and it's to the surprise of the others themselves that he can see them in an incident involving a situation that he gets himself into. So he remarks, "Who are you people?" And they're like, "You can see us?" So years later, Anton becomes a member of the Night Watch, and he is basically a police to the Dark Watch. He makes sure that they don't kill unnecessarily, and sometimes he has the ability to issue licenses to the people from the Dark Watch to perhaps turn somebody into a vampire or do something that they would have to have a license to do. Now, it's a really complicated film as far as the story goes, and I definitely don't want to spoil it for anybody, but sometimes it can be kind of hard to follow. But let's just say there's a grand scheme at work here with Anton being involved with some of Anton's family members, and I can't really give any of it away because I don't want to spoil the film. But with that said, guys, I got to tell you, by Hollywood standards, it's a very low budget film, but I was kind of surprised by what they were able to accomplish with $4 million. You have a film that looks pretty good. Sure, there's a lot of actual settings that the film was filmed in as far as sets go. You have a very kind of washed out, homeless kind of scenery look to it. But it suits the film. And I would say, once again, as I said in a past review, that that this film benefits from a lack of money. It makes you more creative. Now, sure, the special effects aren't up to Hollywood standards, but like I said, they complement the story very well. And it just goes to show you that you don't need $1 million to or multiple $1 million to make an entertaining film, because once again, this is a film about a character, and that character is Anton. Now, the characters aren't really fully developed in this film, with the exception of Anton, who is the focus of the movie. And I gotta tell you guys, I enjoyed the film. I wish I could tell you more about it, but I don't want to spoil it for you, because it's a film that I had never seen, and part of the appeal of it was getting to see what was going on when I'm sitting there confused about what is going on. But film kind of has elements from other horror films, maybe Underworld, elements of supernatural creatures battling one another, policing one another, with the Night Watch side of the army getting the upper hand as far as being the enforcers. And this is very annoying to some of the Day Watch people, who feel that, you know, why are you guys giving out licenses? Who put you guys in charge? But it's a very fragile balance, and it's a balance that is soon to be broken, because both sides are awaiting the Chosen One. Now, the Chosen One is supposed to come into existence, and whichever side he chooses will be the side that reigns supreme. At least that's as far as legend goes. And there are situations set into effect that a grand scheme that is being manipulated by a certain side to bring this being into existence and to bring this being into their side. But you'll have to watch the film to find out what goes on. Now, like I said, guys, I enjoyed the film. As always, guys, being a foreign film, there's things that are lost in the translation. Even though it's dubbed, there's a lot of elements that are kind of difficult to follow at times. And I had to go back and watch a few scenes again to say, you know, oh, okay, yeah, I missed that. Why did I miss that? But once I got my mind going, it was pretty easy to follow the film, and I enjoyed it. I really liked the character of Anton, and overall, I enjoyed the film. Now, some people have compared this film to the technical achievements of Lord of the Rings and all this, and I don't know where they got that from, because it's no Lord of the Rings, but it is a decent little time waster. Pretty entertaining film. Decent amount of gore and violence. Definitely rated R. And like I said, I enjoyed the film. And I have the sequel, which I thought I had it in here. Do I have it in here? No, I don't have it yet. I ordered the sequel from Amazon. I think it cost like $4. And I'm waiting to see it. But I definitely say, guys, check out Night Watch. You know, you could do a lot worse. Then check this film out. I enjoyed it. It has some decent action scenes and introduces some decent ideas. I mean, you know, like I said, as far as Hollywood standards go, it's not going to blow any of the action films away as far as stunt work and special effects and things of that nature. But it is a decent film, and it introduces, like I said, decent ideas. And I think you guys open your mind a little bit and look past the somewhat cheesy special effects and over dramatic scenes and some parts of the movie. You might enjoy it. So check it out, guys, if you get a chance, and let me know what you think. Night Watch. Take care, everybody, and we'll talk again. And I will be reviewing the sequel when I get it. Should be here sometime next week. See you later, guys.